We're going to add integers today. So let's start with the easiest. How about positive integer plus a positive integer? So I'm going to go positive plus positive. That would be like a 4 plus 2 equals 6. Let me show you what that really means on the number line. It means to go to a 4 and add 2 more in the positive direction. So a positive and add more positive to it, you get a positive 6. We assume the positive sign on the front of it, we don't need to write it. This is an addition sign, and this is a positive 6, okay? Let's try a negative and a negative. Let's say that we have a negative number, and we're going to add to it another negative, and let's find out what we'll get. I think that I'll go to a negative 3, and this says, go to the negative 3, and please add to it 2 more in the negative direction. So I'm at a negative 3, I'm going to add 2 more in the negative direction. So my answer is negative 5. When the signs are the same, you get more of the same. Positive and positive makes a whole bunch of positive. Negative, add more negative, whole bunch of negative. So as long as the signs are the same in addition, you're going to get a number that looks larger. All right, so a negative 3 plus negative 2 is a negative 5. Let's try maybe a positive and a negative. Okay, I think we'll do 6 plus a negative 4. Now, I don't have to put that in parentheses. I'm just doing it for cleanliness to separate the plus sign from the negative 4. You don't have to do that. It just looks neater this way. It's easier to read. This says go to a 6 on the number line and add to that 6 4 in the negative direction. When we go to 6 and we add 4 in the negative direction, we end up with a positive 2. And the reason is that we had more positive to begin with. So I can show it to you on the number line, but you can also think of it like this. We know we have more positive than negative, so we know the answer is going to be positive. Now let's compare the absolute value of 6 compared to the absolute value of 4. Is 2, and we know it's going to be a positive 2 because we had more positive to begin with. All right, I think we'll do a negative 7 plus 4. Now, this says go where? It says go to a negative 7 to begin with, so we'll go right here to a negative 7. And from that negative 7, it says, please add 4 in the positive direction. So I'll move 1, 2, 3, 4. And when I add 4, though we had more negative than positive, I end up with a negative 3. If you don't have the number line in front of you, even though we're adding, secretly in our brain we're taking the difference, which I know is subtract. So look at it this way. Compare a 7 to a 4. The difference is 3. But we know it's a negative 3 because we had more negative to begin with. All right, let's try this one. Let's say that we have 5 plus a negative 5. Now you know what that tells us to do. It tells us to go to a positive 5 on the number line and add 5 in the negative direction. Well, I'm right back where I came from. If you add 5 and you take away 5, you're back where you started at 0. There's a name for this, and the name for what I'm showing you here is, it's called the additive inverse. And another example of the additive inverse would be, if I said 4, the additive inverse is -4. If I said -10, the additive inverse is a +10. So when you add a number and its opposite or its additive inverse, you're going to get 0 every single time. All right, additive inverse. Now let me give you some word problems. Let's see what we can do with them. Let's say that we have a lemonade stand, and on Monday, we made a profit of $6. And on Tuesday, we had a loss of $5. I'll put negative for a loss, positive if you want for that. On Wednesday, it was a good day. We had a profit of $12. Thursday, however, was a really bad rainy day, and we had a loss of $10 by the time it was over with. I made too much lemonade that day. Okay, now, how can we solve this problem? How can we find out if we ended up with a profit or a loss? There are a couple different ways to do it. If you want to do it through addition, we can simply write each of the numbers with a plus sign between each of the numbers and do it that way. So I'll start with Monday was 6, plus a -5. Now I can leave it like that, but for beauty, I'm going to go ahead and put parentheses around it. And then Wednesday was a good day, plus 12. And then I'm going to add to that a -10. Not so good of a day. Now some people will go left to right and just take two numbers as they go. So you can do a 6 plus a -5. And then when you get that answer, you can add 12 to it. And then when you get that answer, you can add a -10. I kind of like to group the positive and the negative. So I'm going to group a +6 and a +12 for a +18. And I'm going to add to that a -5 and a -10. And negative and more negative makes a whole lot of negative. So -5 and -10 is a -15. So I now have the addition problem, 18 plus a -15. Well, you know that there's more positive than negative, so we know the answer is going to be positive. Now, take the difference, please, between an absolute value of 18 and an absolute value of 15. The difference is 3. We know it's going to be a positive 3 because we had more positive to begin with. Okay? Now, let me give you, I'll just give you an addition problem with several numbers, and we'll do it a couple different ways. All right. Okay, let's say that I have a -2 plus a -4 plus a -7. Now, I can leave it like that, or I like to just put the parentheses to make it nice and clean, and you can see those plus signs in there. So I'm going to begin by simply adding all the negatives. Negative and more negative make a big negative here. So 2 and 4 is 6. That's a -6 and a -6 and a -7. All negatives, -13. Let's try one that has a mixture of positive and negative numbers. Let's say I have 5 plus a -3. Plus 7 plus a -2. All right, well, you know what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab my positive, see how many positive I have, and then compare it to how many negative I have. But it's still an addition problem. I'm going to grab the 5 because all the signs are addition. I'm going to take the 5 and the 7 for a +12. And now I'm going to add to it a negative 3 and a negative 2 for a negative 5. Now, when you have one positive number and one negative number, how are you going to know if the answer is positive or negative? It depends on which one you have more of. And I've got more positive here. And how many more positive do I have? What's the difference between an absolute value of 12 and an absolute value of 5? The difference is 7. So we're going to end up with 12 plus a negative 5 is 7. That looks pretty good. Now there's one other thing I want to tell you about, and that is this sign right there. That sign right there means the opposite of. So let me give you an example. Let's say that I have a negative 3, just sitting there real pretty, negative 3. If you see this sign outside the parentheses waiting, it says the opposite of a negative 3. Well, the opposite of a negative 3 is 3. Or perhaps you have 2. That says the opposite of 2, positive 2, is a negative 2. Or I might have, maybe I have a 2x. If I have a positive 2x, that sign outside those parentheses says, what is the opposite? Tell me the opposite of 2x. And the opposite of 2x is a negative 2x. So let's go back to absolute value just a minute. I told you in the last video that absolute value was always positive, and it is. However, let me show you something based on the meaning of this sign. The absolute value of a negative 4, you know, is 4. That's fine. I can be happy with that. Now let's look at this one. First of all, I'm going to solve the absolute value part. The absolute value of a negative 4 is a 4. I bring it out. And that sign right there says, yes, but now I want to know the opposite of that now that you've brought it out. And the opposite of this 4 is a negative 4. If I had a 7, absolute value of 7, it would come out as 7. How many jumps back to 0? So I'll write the 7. But if there is a sign waiting for it, it says once you come out of absolute value, I need you to change that number to its opposite. So the 7 that came out positive is now a negative 7. So I still hold to what I say. Absolute value is always positive, but the answer, once you bring it out of absolute value, can be changed to a negative if there's a sign waiting there which says, I know what you are now, but I'm here and I want you to change to the opposite.